Hello, and welcome to today's home group lesson on The Circle Maker. I hope you've enjoyed this book if you've bought it, and I hope you've also enjoyed the teachings by our amazing team. I know they've done a great job so far. In chapter 11, the title is No Answer. At first glance, you may think that the author is saying that God sometimes does not answer, but he does. God answers our prayers. What he's saying is that sometimes the answer is no. Does God say no? We don't like to think so, but he does. And this is what this chapter is all about. Mark, the author, has a line that says, some of the hardest moments in life are when you've prayed hard, but the answer is no, and you don't know why. These are two difficult statements. And although they are difficult, they are very truthful. Have you ever heard the phrase, the truth hurts? And it's very true in this case. The first part of the statement conveys that the truth that God does say no. Oftentimes, people will make the statement that they are waiting on God to answer their prayer. But the truth is that God has already answered it. He said no. And they don't want to hear it. Some people are praying things today that God has already given them the answer to. And again, that answer was already no. But because it didn't line up with what they wanted, they kept asking. How many of you parents know what that's like when your child keeps asking and asking and asking when you've already given them the answer? Well, Jesus said to pray, your kingdom come and your will be done. And friends, I just want to say that this should be our stance. When we present, as the Bible says, our requests before God, that is what they are. They are requests. They're not demands. They're simply requests. And we give those requests to God. And again, God sometimes says no. I would like to say that this should not discourage you to not be persistent in your prayer. Sometimes God does not give us the answer right away, and persistence is the key. But we must remember that prayer is both listening and presenting. You see, after you pray, have you taken the time to listen for the answer? The other day I sat in my office and I didn't say but two words to God. I'm listening. And this can be so difficult because I had a lot to say to him, but I just wanted to listen. And I knew I needed to listen. Have you taken the time to listen to God? The second part of the statement that Mark made was not just that God says no, but sometimes he says, and you don't even know why. We as creatures of curiosity, we want to know why, don't we? How many of you have ever asked your parents the question when they said no, you said this, but why? We can't treat God like Google. He's not a search engine. When he gives the answer, we thank him and we move on. Mark makes one more statement in that line of thinking. He says, and you may never know why. Wow, that's a hard truth, but it is truth. He goes on to speak about the litmus test of trusting God, saying, do you trust that God is for you even when he doesn't give you what you have asked for? Do you trust that he has reasons beyond your reason? Do you trust that his plan is better than your plan? Remember the scripture in Isaiah 55 that says this, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Mark, the author, goes on to give us the benefit of the no answer. You mean, even if God says no, there is still something good that can come out of it? Absolutely. First, he talks about that If you can still trust God when the answer is no, you're likely to give him praise when the answer is yes. And I think sometimes when God answers our prayers like we wanted him to, we get so excited that we forget to give him the glory. The no answer helps us to know that my help comes from the maker of heaven and earth, as the psalmist says. Another benefit of the no answer is as Mark speaks, is what he says is the great answer or the greater answer. You see, God may say no to your requests, not because he's being mean, but because he's being merciful. He goes on, the author, to talk about how many times God had a better answer to his requests than what he was actually asking for. Testimony after testimony does he give on how God had the better answer. And I want to say this to you who are watching today. God has a better answer for you. He has a better way. Keep trusting God. He is for you. Sometimes we need to let go of what we want so we can pick up what God wants. Have you ever heard about how some natives in foreign countries, how they capture monkeys? They hollow out a gourd and they put a hole inside small enough for the monkey to put his hand inside. And then they put food in it and they tie the gourd to a tree. And so the monkey comes along, he sticks his hand in the gourd. He tries to pull it out with a clenched fist and because of the food that he had taken hold of. And the hole was small enough for the monkey to get his hand out, but not with the clenched fist. And all he had to do was to let go of the food and his hand would slip right out. But because the monkey was unwilling to let go of what he thought would sustain him, the monkey would get captured. Friends, I don't know who this is for, but God is saying to you, let go of your will. You're being captured by it, and pick up God's will and be free. As we close today, I would like for you to read and discuss these verses of scripture. 1 John 5:14, Ephesians 6:18, Jeremiah 29:12, Mark 11:24, and Psalm 17:6. May God bless you and keep you and make his face shine upon you. Until next time.